This conference will now be recorded.
Yeah, okay. Let's take a new sheet. How many of you are watching the recordings, Ma? Last class recordings, how many of you have watched? Only one person watch. I think even that also I am.
Sir, even I'm watching it, sir.
But it's showing watch history only one person. That even I think I am the person who is watching. One view is one person and 30 minutes. 13 minutes. Okay. So because whatever you're doing in the class itself, the same thing when Sunday, you're not watching that recordings. Okay. So next, what we are going to do is, filtering with discrete and measures, that is nothing but dimensions and continuous. Okay, this is what the next concept you are going to do it. So now first, so whatever we have done the previous class, now then we are going to see how to filter based on the dimensions and measures or continuous or aggregating discrete. What is the difference between when I filter based on this dimensions, and what is the difference if I filter based on this measures? How it makes the variations? Okay, so that is what we are going to see now. Okay, so for example, if I want to see the sum of sales which is done for subcategories. Okay, so how can I see that? Sum of sales means sales done, the total sales done for subcategory. If I want to see, so what I will do, I'll take the sales and I'll just drag and drop it into columns, and then I'll then take subcategory and drag and drop it into rows. Okay, so this will be nothing but called as what? The sum of sales, the sales done by all the subcategories. I'm getting a report, which is nothing but the sales done by all the subcategories, like accessories, appliances, art, vendors, bookcases, chats, copiers, all this. Right, so now from this wing, I want subcategory. These subcategories are belongs to multiple categories, right? So I think you remember that what are the few categories were there. I want to filter this all the subcategories based on some category. Okay, I want to do filtering. So now what I will do, I'll just take the category from the left side. Okay, on the dimension portion. Okay, on that left side window, I just drag and drop this category to the filters. Now can you see what I'm getting here? So furnitures, office supplies and technology. These are the three different categories are available for me. So for example, now if I take furniture, okay, just I'm taking this furniture and I just click on apply. So can you see what are the reports which are showing the subcategory reports which are falls under the category of furnitures? Okay, so this will be nothing but called as the accurate filter, the exact filter which will be done. And I take dimensions, If I take any fields based on the dimensions, where that exact arc filter will be done. Is that clear? You're getting out of filter based on the dimensions.
Yes, sir.
And we do have many options in this also. And drag and drop this category right here. Like we can filter based on the wild cards, and we can based on the conditions. This all I'll tell you. Okay, on top and this top 10 and all we'll see today what is that, and we can based on the filtering based on like wild cards. Wild cards means, can anyone tell me what are the wild cards are there? Wild card means, anyone know what is that? These are the wild cards. Question mark and the star. So actually this question mark is represents for a single character. And the star is represents for set of characters. For example, I am having some text. Some text starts with A and some text starts with different letter. So I want to find the text starts with A. Okay, so I'll tell you, let's see, for example. Like this. See, in this place, when I want to find a name which starts with A, only starts with A, then I can use this character. Which one? This one. So I can use the starting letter can be anything. Okay, for example, still, even if I want to explain you where I can explain this in a different software. This will be better for me to explain for you in the CMD. It's a command prompt screen. I'll explain you here. So for example, there is a command called as dir. So it shows all the directories, that means all the files in the location. Okay, so now what I will do, I'll go for desktop. Okay, don't keep too much eye on this. It's a different concept at all. The dir, if I give, it is showing me all the files which is there in my desktop. Now I want to see files which starts only with A or B, anything else. For example, dir, a file starts with S and remaining can be anything. Dot, what type of file? Let it be any type of file. So here, can you see the S is nothing but stands for the starting letter, should be S, and star is some set of characters. Let it be any characters. It should be started with S, but remaining can be any characters like Shaker, whatever it is. Dot, what is single means? This question marks are stands for single character like TXT. So it is for only single characters. The one question mark for one character, one more question for one character. So three characters can be anything. In this place, I can give star also, but for extensions, I can't give. See, if I click enter, I'm getting a letters, which means all the files which starts with S. Sales, sample, 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 short. And extension dot XLSX, TXT, XLS, XLS, TWB. I told anything it can be there. In the same place, if I give TXT, names that any files that name starts with X and remaining can be anything dot txt, only text files. So starts with S and remaining can be anything, and the finally the extension can be only txt. Okay, I hope you at least you would have understood what is the concept of that wildcards. Okay, so here I'll tell you, starts with S or A. Okay, filter starts with A. Apply means so take this category out, just mark the category inside. Okay, I select all wildcard starts with, I'm filtering based on the wildcard starts with F, only furniture you think. These are only furnitures. And next, office supplies you think starts with O. These are office supplies like this, and ends with yes you think. Sir, why? Why means technology. Ends with Y. These are technologies. So like are exactly matches whatever I type. Furniture like this. So these are the wild cards. And conditions by the field sum of sales which are greater than some amount. This and all we will see that what is the based on that. And top, this also we'll see. So I want to tell you that wild cards, because one more time also I'll tell you slightly, if you have already knowledge about wild cards, it is easy. Some people will be not having knowledge about like command prompt or like programming, so that will be little difficult understanding what is that wild cards. So star represents some set of characters. When I give a star, that is nothing but in that place any set of characters can be there which replaces that. Question mark means which represents or replaces a single character. Clear? So now what I will do, I'll just take that category, drop it into filters, I'll just take the furnitures, apply, and okay. So now it has been get filtered the exactly only for the furnitures. It has been filtered only exactly for category furnitures. Okay, so this is nothing but how to do filtering based on this dimensions or discrete. Filter using and next the same thing. Filter using continuous or measures. Okay. So now again what I do here in the same place, I take the sum of sales to the columns. And I can take that subcategory to the rows. So the same report what I previously in this place I was taking, the starting, the same thing I'm taking. Now the filter I have to do based on the measures or continuous part. Okay, so if I take this particular portion, if I want to filter based on profit, or if I want to based on sales, whatever I'm doing, just I have to take it from this measures are nothing but called as what, continues. Clear? So let me take that I'm going to filter based on the sales. When I drag and drop this particular sales into filters, so can you see I'm getting a different type of screen when I do this particular option. So previously I used to get the exact filter in this place, in this particular sheet, and drag and drop based on this category, and that is which is nothing but from the dimensions are discrete. But if I go from measures or continues, If I drag and drop this sales to this particular concept of filters, okay, I'm getting something called as different values, which will be get as aggregated. I'm just taking sales. I'm just taking what? Sales to the filters, but it is giving me like some average, median, count, count distincts, minimum, maximum, like all of this under as the options. Okay, which we can say it are aggregated functions where in a different range of values. Okay, for example, we will take anyone from here. Okay, so what we will take? We'll take average or whatever it is. Some only will take, you think. And I go for the next step. Next step, see how you're getting now here. Range of values. We can make it into different range of values. So between. So I want to make this chart. Okay, based on the sales between. That this is the least sales done, and this is the maximum sales done. I want to just adjust this one like from this much to this much. Apply like this. You're getting this one. How to use measures filter? You're getting or not, ma? No sound. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Until here, what I'm telling. Yeah. So range of values, we can just use these portions, or else you can manually enter the values on from starting range and the ending range. Or else, at least it has to be this much values. That you can use it, what is the value should be there. Okay, so from beginning value, at least from this much to this much. So that starting value I'm mentioning, ending value I'm not going to mention. Ending is up to last. From, for example, from 65,000 to at last, that 1 lakh, whatever it is there, 1 crore, whatever it is there, the last value. At least starting from this much. At most, starting from 65,000, or else I'm going to start from this 65,000. The ending, I want to make some changes. Starting from zero and up to 1 lakh, like this. Said 1 crore. Okay, so we can use this one option. And next, options, special null values only wanted. None of the null value should be given here. So if anything are having value zero, okay, that should be there. Non-null values means everything which are having null values, none of that null values should be there in this, and only null values should be given here. And all the values which are given in that, like less or more or zero or more than high or more zero, anything should be there. Let it be that has to be given here. So everything, the changes can be done using this particular filter option. Okay, so very simple. What I have to do, just take the field based from this measures and drag and drop it into the filters. And choose based on what is aggregating functions you want to choose. I'm taking sum. Based on the sum, I'm going to filter this. And you can choose whatever the ranges you want that. Clear, right? So next, just we'll do some basic filter in this place. So done. So here this is nothing but completed. What is what we are talking from previous class? What is the discrete and continuous from the left side? How and all we are using this one? Okay. So we have done with that. The discrete and discrete with this continuous is over here. Just let me save this one. Just click on the file. Just let me close this and reopen this one. So let's take again the same order sheet and let's go for the sheet view. So next we are going to work with the parameter sets and filters. Okay, we are going to like what is the parameter and what is sets and what is filter. Okay, that's our telling, right? Filters, I'll tell you what is that deeply. Okay, the filter, about the filters and how to use that particular filter with the parameters and parameter sets. Okay, and what is the separately sets? That is also we are going to see. Okay, so now what is parameter? Let me explain to you. This can be asked in the interview questions when you're attending. Just note it down. Parameters are nothing but dynamic values which you can change and interact charts. And actually that is nothing but called as what type of, like, bar chart or graph chart, anything you can change. That is not a problem. Okay, what is parameter? Parameters are nothing but dynamic values which you can change and interact with your charts. However, what you having the based on the values you want to make the chart changes. Okay, based on the values you want to play with your chart. So then you can go with this parameters. Is that clear? Just a minute. Sorry, so now let's talk about that. Everyone have opened a new file?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So now I will ask you some questions. You just try to answer me, okay? I want to filter top 10 sales which are done by subcategory, because 5 seconds before or 5 minutes before only think I told about filter. So now at question I'm asking you, I want to show top sales which are done by subcategory, top 10 sales. Show me a report for top 10 sales which are done by subcategory. Do it and send me a pic in the WhatsApp quick. Let's see, you are all sending that with your name. You understood my question? I want top 10 sales which are done by subcategory. You just drag and drop it on your side and do it, and just drop that, take a photo and drop that into that WhatsApp group, our WhatsApp group. I'm waiting. I think by this time would have completed. Anyone have done? I'm opening the WhatsApp group and checking. Somebody will send. Who is one of the first person to send that? Send the pic with your name. Magna, yes, left. Why, ma? This much time? My voice is audible. Top 10 sales which are done by subcategory. Very simple. First, try to find out the sales done by subcategory. Then in that, I want top 10 sales. That means how you will do it. Guys, what is happening? Viba? Who's this? Prajna, very good, excellent. Others? Okay, Prajna has submitted. Any of you others? Okay, Harmain. Okay, next. Only two of you have submitted. Next, Manvi Tanwar. Please. Manavi, what is my question? Just show me the top 10 sales which are done by subcategory. Right? So you're taken in a different method. Good. Maximum sales. Okay, next, any other one? A different thinking. I appreciate. Who is this? Manvi. I told you 10, I think, but here only 9 are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8,
Oh,
9.
yes, so it's 9. Wait, I'll just make the changes.
Yeah, 3, 6. Everyone are doing 9. Why? Okay, I think both are reverse only. 1, 3, 6. Yeah, 10. Okay, so let's do it. So it's very simple. Just this type of things daily are doing the same thing. Drag and drop, right. Some of the sales done by subcategory. Okay, so I told previously some just few seconds, few minutes back. Okay, how can we filter top 10? So just take the subcategory and drop down into the filters. Okay, I told about general, wildcard, and condition. But I went to the top and I stopped that. Why? Because I told that I will tell you that. So just what you do, go for this top. Okay, that's what you have to do. Drag and drop this subcategory to the filters, general, wildcards, and conditions, and go for top. Top. By none is there, just change that to by field top. How much top 10 or top 20? Just make that the changes. How much top 10, which is done by sum of sales? Top 10 sales done by subcategory, top 10 sales done by average, or what? So sales, and I wanted sum only. So I use this particular option. Apply and OK. Okay. So some of you sent like in this format also. It is also right. I'm not telling you wrong. Okay. So both are right. And a different answer is got from Manvi. What you've done? Just you have taken the sales. Okay. And you have done what? In this maximum. In this range. Okay, so at least almost like this. So how can you take this like top 10?
I checked out the profits of all the companies, so like all the products, and the highest profits I just had entered it in the blank box, and the 10th one I manually counted, and I mentioned that number.
Yeah,
so it was quite a manual work.
Yeah, that's why I told in the previous, what is the difference between when I measure from the, sorry, when I filter from the dimensions and measures. Okay, when I say based on subcategory, right, I want top 10 sales based on subcategory. You're trying to filter by sales. The same place, if you just filter by subcategory, this will be very easy. That's not only unique. So yeah, that sum of units on all the batches, people are some of them thinking in this way also. But you have to think about this place. Why this one is better? Why this one is not better? Okay. Why? Because here we don't have any options to do like that. And or else we have to manually calculate here. Okay. So based on this, this can be just enter the values. So just do it based on subcategory. But good. All of you done, tried in a good manner. So appreciate it. For the tries, but the worst feeling is how many of you not sent? Now 6 people have sent. I have some network issues. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. So starting two people have sent. After that, around three people have sent. After that, around six people. Okay, good. Not bad. Very good. Okay. So next question. We'll move on to the next question also. And let's just keep it this in the mind. These are nothing but top 10 sales which is done by subcategory. Okay. Same way, this place, what I'm going to tell you in a different, one more thing. Okay. Let it be this like a filter. I'll just rename it as a filter. So what is the advantage of this in next place? How can you use this one? I'll tell you. One more sheet you take and take the same concept. So okay, so that we can consider just as a like filtering based on the parameters, filtering with parameters. How can I'll tell you that how can all you can filter that way. So now the same thing, I'll take this sum of sales. Okay, I've taken this report. So now each and every time in this place, in the previous sheet, when I want to, like I given top 10, right? I given top 10. So if I want to change from 10 to 20, top 20 or 8, 10, anything else, any number, okay, every time I have to go to that filter and I have to modify. Each and every time when I want to change the numbers, each and every time I have to go for filter and I have to modify the values. Okay, so in the same place, if sometimes we have something like called as a dashboard or like we have seen something like option here, right? Like this. So like this portion, this can be like called as a dashboard also. So if you have something like a dashboard like that, then still it will be very easy for you, right? Okay, I'll tell you how that also. Okay, so when you actually, if you want to use like that, so where it will be like very user friendly, however you want, you can just adjust it. So that time, okay, you will get something called as what? Parameters based on the filters or such. Okay, just I'll tell you how to make that one. So now I'll go just subcategory. I will take it here to the filters. Okay. And I'll go for top 10. Okay. So when I click on this top 10, this arrow mark is the right. Just click on this arrow mark. So below that option, can you see an option is called as named as parameter? Just click on that option parameter and you can give a name for that, any name. Like this. Top some values. Okay, the current value is 10. Okay, I can give any name for that. And below that, just you see, I'll be having many records in between that. How many of that you wanted? Like a 1 to 10 are minimum from 1 and from up to 15. Okay, I think I'm not having that much of values, like 100 and all. So 3, 6, 9, 10, 16, 17 are that. So I'll take us like 15. Okay, so is that getting, you're getting this train. And just what I will do, I'll just click on this apply. That means okay, and just click on this apply and then again on okay. Then you created like this.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so on the left side, you see, can you see a parameter in the left side bottom here in this span here? So parameter has been created in the left side for you here. Top n. So just click on this arrow mark. Okay, so you'll be having an option called as show parameter. Show parameter. You're getting this option. Just click on the show parameter. Can you see on the right side now? A pan is getting visible. The thickness of this details I'll just create it. This will be better of this dimension details. So please confirm you are getting anything parameter on the right side. If anyone of you not getting, please tell me. I'll tell you how to create that. Yes or no? You got it?
Yes, sir.
What about others?
Yes, sir.
Good. So now below that, can you see this? How and all you want, you can just move it. 1, 2, 4, 6, 7, 11. Based on that, just moving that, the parameter, just I will come to know that. That's called as dashboard on the right side, which is called as the dashboard. Having the dashboard, just easily I can manage. Should be the easiest option, right? Each and every time I no need to go to that filter, click edit filter, and I no need to change the values. When you have a dashboard, so easily they will just slide and adjust that and they'll find the value. Just again, I click on this top end. So where this values manually, if you want to enter, so instead of moving this, see this 10, I want to change. Instead of moving this when it's a very length, okay, sometimes I don't want to use that this particular slider, but I want to enter the value manually, which will be helpful for me. But even I wanted to require that particular dashboard here, because if little more are there, where in case in this place like 30 are there, I can't exactly move that which value I want to set it. So that time what I will do, just click on this arrow mark. And you will be having an option called as what? Type in. There is an option called as type in, right? Just click on this type in. So if you want typing method, you take typing method. And if you want, don't want typing method, I'll take the slider method. Just take the slider method. And in the same case, if you want to edit the parameter, you can just edit the parameter. And one more option. And if you want to edit the title, you can edit the title also. Like this. Clearing, right? So this is nothing but like parameter with filters. How to use the filter with help of parameters, which will be very easier and quicker to complete your work. Okay, next we'll go for the another one. So you've done the parameters filters, and next we'll do with parameter with sets. Okay, so just I'll create it. Okay. Okay, so now take 5 minutes break. Okay, so like 5:25 we'll start off. same. Charikyu Dahoud network issues. Okay. I think the extra 2 minutes are got over. Okay, shall we start? Okay, now let's show you that how to do parameter with search. Okay, now the same thing what we have done in the previous concept, the same thing only here you also take it based on the subcategory, sales done by subcategory. Okay, so I'm getting a report. Previously, I used to use filters, and now I'm going to use sets. So what is that set? Sets is nothing but called as some collection of few elements. Sets is nothing but called as what? Collection of few elements. So now I taken sales and subcategory. Okay. So now I'll do something which is when I don't have like filters options, or else if I want to use the sets. So sets means that is nothing but I can create something together, and I can differentiate that particular things with when I compare to another one. Okay. So where in this place I'll just show you see. I'll just take this subcategory. Can you see subcategory here? Just click on the subcategory and create, and there will be having an option called a set where I can create a set. Okay. Sometimes, as I told you, sometimes if I not have some numbers, I will have some parameters where using the parameters also I can work. Okay, when I don't have numbers, so I'll be not using the numbers. I'd use the filters, right? Based on the top 10. In the place of where I'm not having the numbers, or I don't want to filter based on the numbers, where I can filter based on the parameters. Okay, and parameters, how I can use the parameter with sets. So that is what we are going to see here. Just click on the subcategory and go for create and sets. Okay, on this concept, just what I will do, and I click on create sets, go for right top 10. Okay, so in this, just 1 second, just create con top 10. Okay, once you click on this top 10, you can create a parameters. So see, can you see here left side subcategory sets? Can you able to see a set is created separately and a new logo has come for you?
Sir, can you do it once again, sir?
Yeah, I'll do it. I'll delete it. See here. Yeah. See what I'm doing. Just I click on this subcategory, go for create set. Before we used to create parameters. Now I create set. Okay, so set is nothing but some collection of elements. What and all that? Based on the elements by field, top 10. Okay, which is there here. Just select that. I'm going to create that based on the top N. Okay, just select the parameters top N, which we created that already that parameter, right? The top N parameter you select. Don't select that entire value or create parameter, which is already we having that parameter which we created previous set. That one you take it. Okay, and just click on OK now. So now left side automatically you can see subcategory set. You are getting this one?
Yes, sir.
So now what you do, just you try to drag and drop that into color. See what is happening. Can you see the difference? When I said top 10, which are in, which are out. So however you want to manage that, you can manage that using this sets. Like just click here, show set. Here. I just remove that set also. It will be easy for you to understand. Just I don't want to save that set. Just I'll show that filters also if you want. In, I want to show only the in and I want to show only the out. So like this, I can concentrate on this. Okay. Okay, so just which are like all if I take. So which are the grayed out, these are nothing but out on my rule, what I given. And these are which are there, these are inside my rule. Okay, so however I want, I can filter that. And what happens? I just take this parameter and show this parameter. Top 7 is that, and I just make top 9 automatically. Can you see here? Top 12. So it will be very easy for me to highlight some set of fields. Okay, so which are out? These are not out. Just show me the top 5 means. Just what I will do, I'll just drag it to top 5. So where only the 5 will be highlighted, remaining will not be highlighted. So this is nothing but called a set. So where in the places I'm showing everything, but only I'm highlighting the top 5. I'm not showing only 5. I'm not just highlighting the top 5. Understand this one? And just what I'll do, I'll just click on this. Rename that. This will be better for me. Just edit the set. I edit the set. I get a different name. Okay. So subcategory, subcategory, what is happens? I'll have a different name. So when I change the name. This one. In, out, and in is nothing but whatever I mentioned top things which are false under my criteria or condition what I specified. Okay, so that will be highlighted with this color. Which are false, which are not falling on that criteria or condition what I mentioned, which are graded out like this in that gray color. So you're getting this one. Just make me a confirmation once if you're getting this one.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Others?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, you save this by one and don't close it. We have to continue with that still. Okay, so let's take a new sheet here. Now let's see separately how to this concentrating on creating sets. Okay, what are different differently? Just I showed you how to create sets now with the parameters, how to create the sets for the parameters. That is what I'm using, the sets with the combining of the parameters. If I want to use the sets separately instead of using it with the parameters, how can I use the sets separately? So that's we will see here. Okay, so like how to use the sets with bar chart, or how to sets use with like other plotting maps and all. Okay, that and all we will see it here, how to use the set in different places. Okay, so now first what we will do, I'll create something, a bar chart. I'll create a bar chart. So where subcategory to the columns, and sum of sales to the rows. What happened? So I'm creating a graph, right? It's a bar graph. Yes, once if I created the bar graph, just let me make it like descending order. Okay, it should be easy for me. Done. So if I want to show this in the graph, I can take this as a bar chart. The same thing. Now, if I want to use my sets, whatever I use the set, right, to this place, how can I use this one? Okay, so that without parameters, anything else, how can I use the sets for that? Bar graph or whatever graph, just how can I use this one? You just see, just I'll drag and drop that sets into colors. This is one method. So what previously what I've created the sets using that set, I can use in this method. Just a dragging drop. And the same thing, one more method what we can see. We'll take another options. So here I've taken it, I wanted a different map. So what I'm doing, I'm taking sum of sales and sum of profit here. Okay, so where I'm getting only one thing. So based on the subcategory, if I differentiate this one, I'll get a scatter map in this place. So what I'll do, I'll take the subcategory and drop it into colors so that I'm getting the scatter map. So previously I used this column bar chart, okay, with the sets. Okay, same thing, how I will use the sets in the place of scatter map. Okay, so now I created the scatter map. Have you created this one? We have done in the last class also how to create a scatter map. Okay, so now like top four or top five, whatever I wanted, I want to create a set like this. So now what I will do, I just select like this. And once if I select, just place the cursor on any one that round shape for few seconds, you'll get a dialog box. And just can you see this round? Just create. Okay, so now what you can do, just you can create a set or you can add this to my sets. This also you can add to my set, which is my set is previously what you use, right? The top 5, 7. Okay, that is what previously what I'm having one set. You can add this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this 6 values to that particular, what is the previous set I'm having, right? To that we can include this one, or else you can remove only these 6 fields from the whatever the previous my set I'm having, right, from that my set. Okay, or else you can create this with a new shed. Okay, and you can give a new name for that. I'll give like set like this. Okay, so the same place, how can I do that for bar chart also? That is also same, no issues. And like how I can do it. Like this. So when I see this chart, something which are I feel which are lower values, just select that again, keep that cursor. For this also the same procedure. Understood? Clear this one. You are getting this or not, ma?
Yes, sir.
So after creating that sets, again I'll drop it into colors. So which will differentiate this thing? The set three, I dropped into colors here. The set three. So now next I will ask you some question. Okay, so how you can do in a different however you are getting a thought, how will you create this one? You just tell me that. Okay, if I want to create search for all the subcategories which have top five sales done by them, then how you will do this one? Okay, I'll just tell you the question again. Okay, I want to create a set of all subcategory which have top five sales done by them. Top five sales done by the subcategory. Create a set for this. How you will create?
So is it by adding subcategory to the column and sales to the rows, and again the subcategories to the filters, and then we'll edit the filter on the top, you know, the top option, or we select by the field as top 10 and we get one chart. So when we select all, because these are the top 10 charts, so we'll select them and create a set.
Yeah, good. So whatever you told is also right. So however you want means how to filter based on that way, because I'm not given, I have added one more word based on sets, and I create based on I want to create a set. You think, okay, think that I want to create a set of all five subcategories which are top.
So the only option? Click subcategory and create set, and it's there top on the right hand corner, and then by
okay.
field top
okay.
five.
Okay, this is what you are telling, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and then
top on the right hand corner.
Okay,
and top five, I mean enter a value five, and then create set. Okay.
So previously who have answered? Same, the first answer who gave me?
It was me, sir. Manvi.
Manvi, what is the difference between that one and you told?
So mine is a bit a long process, sir. Hers was a bit crisp.
Understood, right? Yeah. So the filter, you told that we will use filters are in that subcategory, you will take that 5-1, right? Okay, when I use the sets, it will be little small easier method and drag that set for under colors. So the problem is solved. Okay, so I think this is 10. I told the question about 5. Good. So, but both of you, what you given answer is 100% right answers, not at all wrong. But the way how you can make it simplify is nothing but Tableau. You have to make it very easy. So then your work also will be very easy. You can smoothly complete your work. Okay. Or else, one more
so
thing.
We can,
so we can
highlight the top 5 and right click and create set also.
That is also a very good answer. Just told top 5. So however, very less values are there. She has told me, I'm having very less values. So easily I can just grade it out and I can make it like what? These are the top. I can create a set like that. But if this method, what I told you, when we have large data and where I can't make it like ascending, descending order, where I can't make it ascending, descending order, and I'm having a very large data. Okay, that times what I told, this method would be very, very useful in company data. Okay, then smaller means very easy, easily as you told also we can make it. But I'm having very large record and the place where I can't able to make the ascending, descending also, it will be not perfect for that particular place. So on that particular place, which will help me to do this is this, whatever I told the last method, right? This one will help you out to do this method. Understood, right, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, very good. Okay. So the final concept, just still 10 minutes are there. Just go for another one. Okay. These are all sets, set one, set two. How and all use the sets with parameters and differently how to use one with sets, I told you. So next you are going to do a concept called as combine. How to combine some multiple fields, which are like basically like if I want to combine subcategory, category, that and all, how to do that, I'll tell you. It's just nothing but called as combining. Okay, so combine is nothing, basically how to combine two or more dimensions together in this particular place. So the dimensions are the right. How to combine two or more dimensions together. So that what you will, what is the benefit of that means? So that you can analyze the data in more easier method. Okay, I'll show you that how. So for example, if you take category, the rows, and subcategory, the rows. Like this. Okay, so I'm getting the categories here and subcategories in this place, and if I take the sales and I drag it into this place or in the text, both are same, I'll get the values. Okay, so just I'll make it the descending order, largest from largest to smallest. Okay, so where in the furniture chairs are like this value. Okay, it's coming like this, and office supply separately and technology separately. So again here two large values, again smaller, again larger, again smaller, which makes something like confusable for me and where I can't easily analyze largest to smallest. Easily I want to analyze what is the top value and what is the less value. You tell me in this entire thing which is the largest value. Even I arranged from the largest to smallest descending order, you tell me in this column which is the largest value.
Phones.
Which one? You can tell me that category or subcategory name. This is the largest value which is having, sir.
So technologies or phones.
Phones, yeah. Technology phones, right? It is having 1.7. So this type of place, what happens? I'm getting confusion and I can't able to analyze my data in a proper manner from largest to smallest hour effort. So in this case, what I will do, if I combine the category and subcategory, it will help me to analyze the data in easier manner. Okay, you see how it helps for me to do that. Yes, I clear this. Just I'll go top, little top, top, where I can see category and subcategory together. Just I take this category, just hold the control key and select the category and scroll down, and I hold this control key and select the subcategory and just click on this arrow mark, create combined field. Create combined field. So now can you see in the left side? A field has been created, which is combined for category and subcategory. So now you just drag and drop into rows. And then you take the sales and drag and drop it into this. And largest to smallest. Can you see now? Telephone technology phones are the, which is the highest sale, it's done. Clearing how to get that? The telephone is nothing but which is the highest sales done. And the next copier based on the category, categories like technology and subcategories like copier. Furniture is the category and chair is the subcategory, like that. So which you helps me to combine and to analyze or understand my data in an easier method. It's very easy for me to understand that, like this also. Understanding?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good. Okay. Okay, first 5 minutes there. First finish off the assignment, sir. Attendance. This is it. Just a second. Just give me a moment. Okay, Prajna.
Present, sir.
Vashika, Bindu,
present, sir.
Pooja,
present, sir.
Sanjana, Sanjana. Sorry, Q Dawood.
Present, sir.
Prajal Sharma. Chaitra V.
Present, sir.
Anjana.
Present, sir.
Sultana.
Present, sir.
Akila Fatima. Akila Fatima. Harmain Jara.
Present, sir.
Viba.
Present, sir.
Okay, Tanva.
Present, sir.
Akshata.
Present, sir.
Maria.
Present, sir.
Meghana, yes.
Present, sir.
Vita.
Present, sir.
Okay, in the list 15 are there, present are 14. Okay, understood, right? So whatever we have covered today, just to practice once all that whatever you have done until today, I think the last 3 days you have done many practical things. Please do it, everything, practice it. Okay, we have weekend, just practice, okay? And submit the assignments which are pending previously, whatever it is there.
Excuse me, sir.
Just tell me, ma.
Can you show sheet 6 for a second, sir?
Yeah, I'll show you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Welcome, welcome. Okay, so others.